No one likes this infinite looping indicator. So when you have a large file to download, it's a good idea to show download progress indicator. And that's the agenda of our this video. We're going to implement this nice animation inside Flutter application real quickly. Hello and welcome back. My name is Afzal and you're watching channel Code X. If you remember, in last video, I asked you to provide feedback and I got a lot of positive comments on the video. So at the end of video, I'm going to announce two viewers who won license copy for Eagle software. Let's jump into today's tutorial. Here we are going to achieve download progress bar with percentage indicator. So far, I have created a centered body. Inside that, we have a column. Now we'll start our layout with floating action button. Let's proceed with the blank onPress method. And for label, we'll use a text widget. Here I'll say download. Now let's see how it's looking on the UI. Fine, this is going on top, no issues. Let's provide icon quickly. I'm going to say maybe download icon. Fine, this looks great. Now we have to bring this button down. How we can do? By providing main access size minimum. If you want to know more about this column and behavior of column, you can check my last tutorial, link in the description below. So we got our button in the center. Now everything is going to happen inside this onPressed event. Downloading file, updating progress, everything. So let's go to our pubspec YAML and specify the necessary libraries. We are going to use DIO or DIO, whatever you call it, and path provider. Any version is fine with us. We don't need to be specific with that, at least for this demo purpose. Now let's go back to our file, our download page. Here we are going to initialize instance of DIO class. This DIO will be used, basically it's a networking library. So this can be used for get request, post request, put delete and all kind of a REST API. But what we are going to use here is the download method of DIO class. As you can see, it's asking for two parameters by default. One is the URL path from where it will download and second is the location where it will save. So I'm going to provide this URL which has a 5 MB image. You can use any URL, doesn't matter really. And for path where it will save, we'll have to fetch the directory. For that, we are going to use path provider. Path provider has a method called get external storage directory, which will give you the directory of external storage as the name suggests. And it's a future. So for that, we'll use async and await. So we'll make our method async and we'll use await keyword. Now this directory, if you see, is a path actually. It's a directory object. Now using string interpolation, we'll use a path of this directory and we'll append with the file name where it's going to save whatever it downloads. Quite simple till now. Let's run it quickly and see. It's giving the missing plugin exception because we'll have to rerun the application. It happens when you add package to your pubspec and don't restart the application. That's fine. Now what we have to do is we have to show this progress message, right? For that, we'll create a state level variable. And here I'll initialize it with something generic called initializing, something like that. We will also create one Boolean flag to check whether it's downloading or not. Let's initialize it with false value. Now we are going to create a label below this floating action button, which will show the actual status of downloading. So it's a good idea to check for null value whenever you are using a text widget. So by default, we get that initializing text here. Let's use size box for spacing, vertical spacing. I'm going to put 32 pixel and this is looking okay. Let's change the value of is downloading on pressed event. So is downloading will make it a reverse. If it's downloading, we'll make it not downloading and vice versa. And we'll put this inside a set state method so that it refreshes the UI. Now the most important part of this tutorial. We have to update download message as the downloading progresses. Fortunately, we have onReceiveProgress event inside download method of Dio, which gives actual bytes downloaded and total bytes available to this file. So with that, we can show the current progress. Let's change the value of download message to actual bytes. Now this actual bytes is the bytes it has downloaded so far. So let's run it and see how it's going to look like. So when we click on this download button, we can see that bytes are updating real time. Now it's time to announce the giveaways. So the first viewer who got this license for Eagle Software is Sovandi No. And the second viewer is John Azeka. Congratulations to you guys, and sorry if I pronounce your name wrongly. I'll reply on your comment and from there we can take it forward. Now back to our tutorial. We already displayed the bytes progressing. Now we have to calculate percentage. I'm remembering my school days, you know, we used to calculate percentage like marks obtained divided by total marks into 100. See, it's useful. Okay, now let's replace this actual bytes to the percentage. And using a string interpolation, we'll add prefix and suffix to this percentage value. Now let's run and see. We are getting this downloading percentage real time. We're using this onlinesamplevideo.com for sample image, and we are downloading this image real time. Now we'll just add some styling to the text so that it looks real nice and bold. And we're almost there. Just one last thing to do is to add the linear progress bar. This linear progress indicator accepts a value which is a double. So now let's declare a variable called percentage. So let's use this percentage in the place of value, and let me tell you that this value ranges from 0 to 1. So we have to divide the actual percentage by 100 to get this linear progress indicator work correctly. Now the percentage value, we already have it. So what we are going to do is to the state level percentage variable, we'll assign this percentage and we'll divide it by 100. Finally, I'm going to wrap this linear progress indicator inside a padding widget to give some left and right padding, and we have our download progress bar ready. Now when we click on download, we can see that it's downloading, it's showing the percentage, and the progress bar runs along with it. Now you can add more functionality to it. You can check for the percentage completion, whether it's successful, whether it's 100% completed. You can show different message. You can put this entire thing inside a dialog to show a dialog pop-up with the percentage completion, and you can play around with the different things. But the whole idea is to show a progress indicator with percentage whenever you have something big or something large file to download. Thank you so much guys for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed, you learned something new. And if you like the video, do subscribe the channel, give your feedback and hit the like button. Thank you so much once again. See you in the next video.